In this hands-on lesson, we're going to deploy some infrastructure through AWS CloudFormation. In your course download, you'll find three files, which are in the code and CloudFormation directory. So you've got create S3 bucket CF. This has got a number one in front of it, and then there's number two and number three. So we're going to work with these templates and use these to deploy some infrastructure into CloudFormation. Now, what we're actually going to deploy is going to be an Amazon S3 bucket, and we're going to apply some configuration to that bucket. Now, there's just one thing you need to do for now, and that is you need to enter a bucket name where it says enter bucket name. Now, do make sure it's in lowercase because you can't use uppercase, and make sure it's something unique. So I've given mine a bucket name, which I believe should be unique, and I'm just going to save my file. Now, what this file is going to do is very simply deploy the S3 bucket. So we can see that this is a very, very simple template written in YAML. We have our resources specified. We have a resource, which is an S3 bucket. And you can see it's the type AWS :S3:bucket. Then we have a description, and then we have the properties. And there we have simply specified the name that we want to apply to the bucket. There's then some outputs. Now, the outputs are important information because we can use these outputs in other stacks or externally. So here our output has a description, and then it has a value, which is going to be the bucket name. So that's all we need to do here. Let's go over to CloudFormation and deploy our S3 bucket. So I'm logged into CloudFormation here, and what we need to do is create a stack. So I'm going to choose create stack with new resources, and I'm going to select the prepare template and then upload a template file. And then we simply need to choose our file. So let's choose this number one create S3 bucket CF.yaml, upload, click on next. We need to give it a stack name. I'm going to call mine create bucket CloudFormation, click on next. Now we have some options to apply things like tags. We can set the permissions, so the IAM role that's going to be used. Now note that if you don't choose a role, it's going to use the permissions assigned to your account, so your user credentials. Now I do have the permissions to actually deploy this stack, so I don't need to specify a role. The default stack failure option is to roll back all stack resources. So if something during the stack creation process fails, CloudFormation will attempt to roll everything back again, so there's nothing left running. Doesn't always work, so you've got to check, but it is a very, very useful feature. Now, we're not going to apply any advanced options. Let's just click on next. We can scroll down to the bottom. We need to select this checkbox and then choose create stack. And now our stack creation is in progress. If you hit refresh, you will get the updated status, and here we can see that the creation is complete. Now, if we go to outputs, we should now see that we have an output, and that has the value, which is the name of our bucket. If I go over to Amazon S3, and I'm going to hit on refresh here, and now we have an extra bucket here. So this is the bucket that was created by CloudFormation as part of our stack. You'll also notice that CloudFormation has this templates bucket, and in here it actually stores the files that it's using. So it's created two buckets. Now if we go in and have a look at our bucket, it's going to have some basic settings applied. If we go to properties, for example, we can note that there's no default encryption enabled. That might be something we want to do. Also, if we go over to permissions and click on edit here, you'll notice that the setting, which is a default if you actually create your bucket through the console, isn't actually selected, so it's not actually blocking public access. So that's something to think about if you use CloudFormation to deploy your S3 buckets. You might want to specify to disable public access in your template. So what we're actually going to do next is we want to apply default encryption to our bucket. So we're going to go back and have a look at the second template, which is going to do that for us. So this is the template for updating the bucket to have server-side encryption enabled. Now don't forget to update your bucket name. It needs to have the same bucket name as before. And literally all we've added now is this piece here. So it now has bucket encryption, server-side encryption configuration, server-side encryption by default, and then the SSE algorithm is AES-256. And that means it's going to use the S3 managed encryption. So I'm happy with that. Let's save my file and let's go back to CloudFormation. Now, I don't want to create a new stack. I want to update my existing stack. But let's say that I want to see what the differences are going to be. You can create a change set. And with a change set, we can actually view what the potential changes will be. So I'm going to replace my current template, upload a new template file, and then choose my file and select number 2. Click on upload, click on next, next again, and leave the default options, and then go through to create our change set. And you'll need to check this box here. So let's create change set. I'll accept the default name and create change set. Now, this won't take long. It should take 30 seconds or so to complete. Now, it's actually completed in probably about 5 or 10 seconds, so very, very fast. Now, we can see that the changes are that there's going to be a modification. Doesn't really tell us too much detail. Depending on what resources you're updating, sometimes you can get more detail. But if you go to the JSON changes here, we can see here that the target is bucket encryption. So we're updating the encryption status of our bucket. So I'm happy with that. I can execute my change set now that I know what's going to happen. And that didn't take long. That update has now completed. Let's go back over to look at our bucket. I'm just going to refresh the page. And now we can see that default encryption is enabled for our bucket. The last thing I want to do is I want to enable versioning for my bucket. So now I'm going to run another template, make sure to update your bucket name as before. And this time we've got the previous settings applied, but then also we have this versioning configuration here. And that status is enabled. Now there's actually one more thing I want to do. I want to make sure that when I delete my stack, it doesn't delete my bucket. So sometimes you might want your CloudFormation stack to roll back everything that it's done and delete the resources that it's created. Other times you may want to make sure that doesn't happen. So you can use the deletion policy and specify retain. So I'm going to put in deletion policy, colon, space, and then we're going to put retain. And now I'm going to save my template and let's go back to CloudFormation. Let's go back to find our stack. Click on update this time and I'm going to update it directly. Choose to upload a template file. Choose my file and select number 3, upload, and then again, we just go through with the default settings. And finally, we can update our stack after selecting the checkbox. So let's update the stack. So that's done. Let's go back to our bucket and the versioning should now be enabled. So let's just refresh the page and we have versioning. Now, what if I actually change one of the settings that's been applied through the template? Let's go into default encryption and I'm going to disable that change. Now, if I go back to CloudFormation, go to stack actions, detect drift, and what it's going to do is it's going to have a look at the last template that we uploaded and it's going to check if the actual configuration of our bucket differs from the configuration specified in the template. So that's happening in the background. Let's go to view drift results. And we can see that the status is modified. Again, it really depends on the resource. Sometimes you get more information that you can use, but at least I know now that the configuration of the bucket does not match my template. So I can do some more analysis. Now I'm finished with this stack. So what I want to do is simply go in and delete my stack. Now what should happen, because we set the deletion policy to retain, is it should complete fairly quickly, but it's not going to delete our bucket. So let's go back and make sure that our bucket is still there. And it is. So that's all worked successfully.